Turning to medical news on the Healthbeat this morning, teens donating blood. More are doing it every year, but Dr. Barry Ramo explains that some could experience a rough reaction.
U.S. teenage blood donation is increasing across the U.S. Teens as young as 16 are now allowed to donate blood in these 22 states. Most require parental consent. Kansas and Oregon do not.
The blood supply depends on the commitment of our volunteer donors.
Dr. Ann Eder is the executive medical officer at the American Red Cross. She says teens are enthusiastic donors and they're also more likely to experience some unpleasant side effects.
In 16 and 17-year-olds, 11% will experience a reaction compared to 8% of 18 and 19-year-olds and about 3% of donors older than 20 years.
Researchers at the national headquarters of the American Red Cross studied about 145,000 teenage donations from 9 of their regional blood centers in 2006. They found the majority of adverse reactions in 16 and 17-year-olds are mild, including lightheadedness and dizziness. And a small number, if they stand up quickly, could even fall.
We believe the study indicates a need for awareness and preparedness, especially on high school blood drives.
The report and the video from this story come from the Journal of the American Medical Association. Injuries to young donors usually occur after donation in the refreshment area or in the restroom or in another area of the school.
It is important to have well-trained staff to recognize and treat reactions. We collect this data so that we can understand what's going on and so that we can evaluate the steps that we take, hopefully to improve safety.
For Healthbeat, I'm Dr. Barry Ramo, KOAT, Action 7 News, live this morning.